Hello participants of the Super Speakers Debate Championship. In the previous video, I explained what the basic concept of debating is and why it is so important. In this particular short video, I'm going to be explaining the two formats of debate that we are following during the Super Speakers Debate Championship. Now, before I go into these two formats, let me tell you that there are multiple different formats of debating that exist across the world. And honestly speaking, there's a lot of innovation that takes place with them. There are different formats at the university levels, at the college levels, at the school levels, and so on. Typically in India and in Asia, there are 2 to 3 formats that are very popular, including the Frank Anthony Memorial style, which is also called the modified Cambridge style, the Bombay style of debate, which is also called the modified Oxford style, and finally the Lincoln Douglas style, which is popular across the globe. The debating formats that we are going to be following typically are, in fact, we are following 2 debate formats. We're going to be following the Frank Anthony Memorial style, which is also called the modified Cambridge style, and the Bombay style of debate, which is called the modified Oxford style. So we're following 2 debate formats. Okay, both of them have slightly different approaches. Typically, irrespective of format, every debate has a proposition, one person or a set of people speaking for the topic, and opposition, that is one person or a set of people speaking against the topic, okay? So we have an opposition and we have a proposition that speak for and against the topic. There is a moderator who presides over the debate, making sure that the flow of the debate is fine. He or she doesn't participate in the debate, just make sure that the opposition and a proposition are in decorum. And finally, there are such a set of judges who mark everything. Okay, so that's basically how any debate works. Okay, so moving on beyond this, what's very important for you all to understand is that in any format, there are 3 golden rules. Content is king. Making sure that you make your best points is always going to matter more than anything else. Being disciplined and dignified, maintaining poise, calm, and composure is important. And thirdly, and most importantly, don't make a debate an elocution. Okay, a debate is not an elocution. An elocution requires you to be flowery, have a lot of phrases, have a lot of beautiful words being said. And while this is great to have in a debate, what's more important is substantive points, points that are facts and arguments that back your side of the topic. Okay, so that is very, very important. Okay, so these are 3 things. Now I'm going to go ahead and explain the Frank Anthony Memorial style of debate format to all of you. This is the format that we'll be following for the prelim round. Okay, it's only for the prelim round that we'll be following. It's also called the modified Cambridge style. And you'll see this format being followed in a lot of ICSE schools across India. It's also being followed in many other boards like the IB board, IGCSE board in modified formats. And that's why we have decided to simulate the prelims using the Frank Anthony Memorial style. Okay, so basically in this style, the focus on the speech is more important than the focus on the cross argument, which is called a rebuttal. So any debate comprises of 2 major parts, your speeches, where you speak without being interrupted, and rebuttal, which is like a cross questioning and answering process where the proposition and opposition get to directly argue a point out with each other, questioning why somebody said something and then counter questioning. So that's a process which goes on. In the Frank Anthony Memorial style, the speeches are more important. And in this format, there are multiple people who can participate together. So typically, there are 2 sides to the topic. One is the proposition, people speaking for the topic, and one is the opposition, which is people speaking against the topic. So we have a proposition and an opposition. There can be any number of people on the proposition side and the opposition side. For example, we can have 10 people for and 10 people against, but all of these people actually participate as individuals. So even if you have 10 members on the for side, each of them participates individually, and 10 members on the against side, each of them participate individually. Okay, there is a moderator who presides over the session and judges who mark you for your participation. Okay, so basically what happens in the Frank Anthony Memorial style of debate is that the format is as follows. There is a motion or a topic on the floor. Okay, this is typically given only 1 hour prior to the debate. Okay, so we too at the Super Speakers Debating Championship will also give it to you just 1 hour prior. You can use any media and resources to prepare. Parents, please make sure you do not help your students. Let them go through the learning process themselves and evolve. It is just a learning opportunity. So we would request you to avoid helping the students during this 1 hour. So after this 1 hour is over, the debate starts. First, one member of the proposition or the side speaking for the topic speaks up. You will get 2 minutes to speak up. Okay, it's 2 minutes to speak up during this period. Once you have spoken up for a period of 2 minutes, there will be a rebuttal round. Okay, so basically once you complete your speech, the moderator will allow participants on the other side. If you are the proposition, then participants from the opposition, the moderator will allow 2 people to ask you questions. Okay, two people will be allowed and you have to answer them as briefly and as succinctly, as crisply as possible. Okay, which two members of the opposition get to ask a question depends upon who raises their hands and who is recognized by the moderator. Okay, so there is a 2-minute speech followed by two questions. After this, one member of the opposition speaks up similarly for 2 minutes and is asked two questions by the members of the proposition. Then we go back to the next speaker in the proposition. 2 minutes followed by two questions, then opposition. So this way, proposition, opposition, proposition, opposition, until we are done with all contestants. As I said, no members of the proposition or opposition participate together in teams. Everybody is an individual and you are marked individually as well. All right. Individually, the basic parameters on which you are marked on are the quality of speeches you're delivering. How good is your delivery quality, your basic eloquence, your basic voice projection, your logical fluency, your voice modulation, your body language, the quality of content. How many good facts and arguments are you making in your speech? As I mentioned, debating is not simply about flowery language. It's about facts and arguments more than anything else. All right. So that's the second point. Third is, what is the quality of answers you give to the question? So that's basically the rebuttal round. How well did you participate in it? And fourthly, discipline. Discipline, basically, did you adhere to the time limits? Sticking to the time limits is very important. Okay. What's going to happen is that when you have 15 seconds left, the moderator will actually show you a sign which goes like this. 1, 2, 3. This means 15 seconds left. 1, 2, 3. At the end of 2 minutes, the moderator will ask you to conclude. And you will be forced into concluding. We are not going to give extra time to speak up. Within 2 minutes is what everybody gets. So we will not allow any further extensions to it. But if you continue speaking post that, you might lose marks for discipline. In addition to this, you're not allowed to refer to papers and read them throughout. You can keep some points which you can refer to. But if you see you reading out of a paper, it might lead to reduction of marks. Okay. So these are the four criteria. The manual mentions exactly how many points per section. That's quality of speeches, quality of content, quality of answers to questions, and discipline. Okay, so please read through this. And this is how the prelim rounds will take place. So you typically have 10 and 10 people participating against each other, or 5 and 5. That totally depends. Okay, so out of these different Frank Anthony Memorial style prelim format debates, 2 people will make it to the next round from every group. It doesn't matter whether those 2 people are proposition or 2 people are opposition. Totally depends upon the points you score. Okay. And you'll be getting the topics 1 hour prior to the start of the debate, on the day of the debate. All right. So I hope all of you are completely clear about this, and all the best for participation. As always, try and focus on making yourselves the best versions of yourselves. Thank you so much. This is Ananj Prasad signing off. In the next video, I will explain the art of participating in the Bombay style of debate.